Good evening, my lovely ladies and gentlemen. This is BestInSlot with the final episode of our Jurassic World Evolution Safari thingamajiggy. Here's all our dead sticky mullocks. Very nice. I do believe we have more on the way. Let me just double check. Yeah, there they are. Let's get these. Wait, what are you? Why is there a baryonyx? Okay, let's shoot the baryonyx. And then release the sticky mullocks. Just try to keep them alive for more than 5 seconds. Anyways, today we are going to work on our final enclosure, and it is going to be a Hell Creek themed exhibit. Kind of a little bit of practice. I'd like to do a park down the line where every exhibit, and we'll go back to building like a proper park, but every exhibit would be based upon like a formation or a time period or something like that. Just all a little bit more scientifically, rigorously researched. And we're going to call this Hell Creek one a little bit of practice. It does mean that in the future, our next Hell Creek one will probably look identical, but it's not a big deal. Let's get all these out because we need the space. We are going to start things off nice and quick here today. We are going to get ourselves our Triceratopses. So I've done a little bit of research into Hell Creek and stuff like that. And obviously we... Didn't know you could get to that screen from that screen, but hey-ho. Let me just reset the sheen. So what colour what's that? Sucumimus Spinosaurus, that's fine. What colours do we want here? I don't really care. I don't want the null one, because the null one's boring as hell. The alpine one's very white. The steppe one is very brown. The arid one, is the kind of yellow one, I think. I think we're going to go for coastal. I think coastal is pretty cool. Let's get a couple of coastals. We're probably going to go for 4 or 5 Triceratopses. I was doing a little research. I don't want to just have... Wait, what was that? I don't want to just have... the right dinosaurs. Part of me kind of wants to have the right number of dinosaurs as well. So I've been looking at what were the most common dinosaurs found within Hell Creek and stuff like that. Now, the most common dinosaur found in Hell Creek was Triceratops. So we're going to have the Triceratops as our most common dinosaur. I think we're going to have twice, maybe 6 of them at the end. Let's go for... We're going to go 2-step, 2-coastal, and I'll figure something else out. So Triceratops, 6. Edmontosaurus was fairly common in terms of the herbivores. He was definitely the second most common in terms of what I've been able to find anyway. And then Tyrannosaurus Rex. Those were the big 3 dinosaurs. Now there were some others knocking around. We're going to bring in an Ankylosaurus, for example. But Ankylosaurus was very, very rare. And I believe Ankylosaurus in this game doesn't have a social need. So what we'll do is we'll have one Anky, which I think will look pretty cool as well anyway. Oh, excuse me, my face just exploded. Oh my god. My ears are ringing. All my dinosaurs are dying. Everything is going terribly wrong, but it's okay. It's okay. Let's get these stiggies shifted over. I think it's just like my baryonyxes and spinosauruses, and they're the ones all dying. What's that? Yeah, Spinosaurus is actually... Oh no, baryonyx is about to die, actually. Oh, yeah, baryonyx is dead. I just shifted a blimmin' baryonyx over, and you've decided to kill them anyway. Grumble. Oh no, that's the wrong one! Oh, I'm sorry, Sticky Moloch. I totally just sent you to your death. I just put a Sticky Moloch in my swamp. Which I suspect will end badly for the Sticky Moloch. Anyways, step and step. We're gonna get one for now. That's a Sucumimus. That's not a Triceratops best slot. We're gonna get one Arid. Mix things up a little bit. I do want 6, I think. Let's get releasing them. Coastal, this is, I think, my favourite. Yeah, Coastal's pretty cool. Still my favourite dinosaur. I don't know why Triceratops is my favourite dinosaur. I can't pin it to like a unique memory as a child or something like that. But I've always liked rhinos. I've always liked the idea of a herbivore that can kind of kick ass a little bit, you know? It's adorable, as you can tell. Look at it, absolutely adorable. But it can fight back, it can kick ass, it can show those T-Rexes who's boss, etc, etc. Let's just get 2 of each. So they're going to get all shifted over here. Now, we should probably build the blimmin' exhibit. That seems like quite an important thing to do. Right, there's not a gap there, that's fine. So we just, all we need to do actually is bring this bit across along here. Oh, we'll just go for electrified, because you're not going to see this anyway. Now, I've had a little idea of how I want to build this. A lot of the pictures I see of Hell Creek now, regardless of what it looked like back there, I think we know what it looked like a little bit back there. I can think of what it looks like in Saurian and kind of use that as a judgment. But I like the idea of having like a ravine, basically. So I think what we're going to do is at least really put a big old hill on this left-hand side. Also, that's going to like create a really cool look for this exhibit, as this is going to get like blocked off from the rest of the world, which I think will look pretty awesome. Could be entirely wrong. Could look disastrous. You never know. But we're going to try. We're going to give it a good old college try. So, raise lots and lots and lots and lots and lots as high as we can go, please, folks. Which is hopefully substantially higher than this. Much higher, please. There we go. There we go. We're getting there. I really want this to be... I kind of want it on both sides, but I think it might look a little weird. Although it might be a really good way to hide the fence. Maybe if I just keep it more like there. So it hides the fence. Without necessarily being too big. And this left-hand side can be the big side of the ravine. And then we'll do like a little river snaking its way through. I'm going to kill this river just temporarily. Sorry, Mr. River. You're a lovely river. You're my best friend. But I have to murder you. Not for the first time in my life. I'm about to do that. That's another story for another day. Let's get all these trikes out. Lovely stuff. And let's get started on the Edmontos. We're going to bring in the T-Rexes last, just because they will kill everything. So I want to save that for when we're ready for the final run-through. Now, Edmontosaurus. There's a rainforest one. We're always going to get a rainforest one. I think we're going to go for 4 or 3 Edmontosauruses. You only need 1 for their social need. Woodland. Sounds good. All my Supermimuses and Spinosauruses and such keep killing each other, which is lovely. We're going to get 3... I don't know. I'm trying to balance it. We're going to go for 2 Rexes. Now, you would have more Rexes than Edmontosauruses based on the actual results, and as well in terms of like the time scale in which these dinosaurs lived in Hell Creek. Triceratops and T-Rex were there quite a bit longer than every other dinosaur, but Edmontosaurus was also a clear 3rd place. So, do I go for 4 and then 2? Let's go for 4. Let's get 4 different colours. Let's live the dream. Bit of tundra as well. And I also want a single Ankylosaurus. Just 1 for the Anky. And colour-wise, let's make it fancy. Which one do we like? Let's go for Rainforest. Rainforest is my faves. Always rely on the Rainforest. Stop killing the Rainforest. If you kill the Rainforest, what colour will I pick my dinosaurs? This is the problem. People don't think about this. People are like... Rainforest, Greenpeace were like, save the rainforest because all these animals will die, right? But what they don't think about is, what colour will BestInSlot paint his dinosaurs if we don't save the rainforest? Come on, Peter. Something so selfish. Right, we're going to flatten this out. Let's build a big old ridge, baby. Big old ridge. Look at that big old ridge. That is the biggest ridge anyone has ever seen. I really want to... I'm going to attack it a little bit. In a little bit. But I do want to... try to give it a natural kind of feeling. Which, I swear those are words I've said about 5,000 times in my life. Let's extend, there's a fence there, let's use it. All the way over here. And then knock that down a bit, because that looks stupid. I like this, the one on the right needs upping a little bit, for sure. And it does mean there's not that much room for the dinosaurs themselves, which seems like a problem, you'd think, but we're gonna make it work. Gonna make it work. Gotta make it sexy. Maybe the ravine actually ends. Rather than it kind of... I was going to have it kind of like peter off, but maybe it just joins in here. It's like an actual end to it right there. I like that. I like that a lot. I do want to keep this left-hand side completely flat, so we can really hide this exhibit within itself. Also, I think it'll make our savannah exhibit look a little bit cooler as well. Plus, it's nice to get these kind of... It's hard to do in this game, but it's nice sometimes to have nice sharp edges in your ravine. They've clearly put a lot of time into making sure it's always very sort of... You know how it looks here, where it's kind of like... it's always very soft and slopey, but sometimes you want a nice hard edge, you know? An edge you take home to meet your mum. I'm just going to attack this a little bit with a slope tool, basically. Just... try to make it look a little bit more natural. That's the idea. Okay. Not bad. Stick some trees on there. I think we might have something. Okay. That's our Hell Creek so far. Dinosaurs. Right. Let's get all the trikes over first because we do have a buttload of them. I believe we have 6. Yep. Choo. 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 No problem.
I don't think I've ever had this many trikes before. They look lovely together.
So we're going to go trike at Montosaurus, Ankylosaurus, Tyrannosaurus Rex, Struthiomimus. Also not going to have many of them. They were very rare. I'm thinking two or three. It's the kind of dinosaur that you can put a lot of them in just because they're small. Pachycephalosaurus as well. Again, Pachycephalosaurus, which I quite heavily associate with Hell Creek, maybe primarily because of Saurian, but I believe Pachycephalosaurus really wasn't a big presence at all. I'm reading a little thing here. Ceratopsidae, a Triceratops, formed 60% of the Hell Creek population. Now, the Tyrannosaurus was only 4%, but it was there for a lot longer, is what I mean. You know, it was always a facet, and if you look at the total sort of size of the dinosaurs and their constant presence, and the T-Rex was a constant presence, basically. So, back to work. Let's release more dinosaurs. Many, many more dinosaurs. Forward Montos, one Anki. It's nice as well when you can get kind of different numbers for your dinosaurs. So I'm thinking like three Struthies. Oh, how many Pachycephalosaurs though? Maybe five Struthies, three Pachycephalosauruses? Something like that. You know what I mean? You kind of want to... all your dinosaurs to be mixed and matched. Anyways, we aren't actually quite blimmin' done, are we? Let's go back to work. I kind of like the idea of... I don't know why I like the idea of, now that I think about it. I'm going to have the river from here carry on, first of all. I want to curl around. I hate how that looks there, but we'll fix that. That's fine. It's definitely got some height stuff going on, hasn't it? I like the idea of this kind of maybe cutting through the mountain. Is that going to look weird? Let's find out. You're not going to let me do it, are you? If I lower, it's going to end up looking weird. Maybe I can do it here. Have it curl into the my exhibit number one over here on the left. If we just lower that down. A lot more than that. If we just flatten. Like so. I really wish you had more control sometimes. Hey-ho! Is what it is. And that goes through there instead. Sure, come on. You cheeky little... come on. Come on, you can do it. I believe. I believe in you. Get in there. Get in there. Just through that. Oh, so close. You can see it joining together as well. It's literally so close. There you go. And that goes all the way through. Joins into there. And it kind of cuts through the mountain. I think that looks really cool. It's going to look better when we get some trees and stuff in there. I want to up this. This whole bit over here is kind of like useless right now. So let's make it big. I'm going to try and make like an actual mountain. As much as you ever can make a mountain. The problem, again, because you can't really have sharp edges, you can't really ever make a mountain. It always just looks like a big-ass hill. But that's a start. See, I can't even make this out bigger, really. Without kind of ruining the whole area around it, you know? That's a start. It kind of looks like a mountain. We'll get some trees in there. It's going to look cool. All of my dinosaurs are dying. There's another that's sticky, which I saw coming. I think my Stiggy in here is already dead. How do I only have one Stiggy Moloch in there? I transferred like five over. They've all died already. It's ridiculous. It's actually ridiculous. I'm really surprised they're all dead. Oh, whatever. Get the trikes over. Okay, so I'm just going to focus on the herbivores for now. That's a lot of dinosaurs. Shoot them all in the facial regions. Fun for everyone involved. I'm sure you'll agree. Anyone else need shifting? No, go above you. Good stuff. I really like how that... I think this is going to look really, really cool. Really, really cool. Really, really cool. Little reference there. Right, how do we make it look... No, I don't like this bit. This bit's bugging me. This little dint. I'm not a big dint kind of guy. I don't know what that means in reality, but I'm going to kill the dint. Can you guys stop fighting? Jesus Christ. I actually want it to be raised, if anything. It should be raised, right? If you've got an island like that, in the middle of the river, I think it would be raised. Do I like that? Oh, I don't know. No, I like that. I think that looks really cool. It's got a very natural feeling to it. And because of these side hills, once I get rid of this blimmin' fence over here... How did we get in here? Do I ever get here? The gate's over there. That's fine. You just
you're just not going to be able to see anything. It's just all going to be this little valley, basically. And we're going to put some trees and stuff in next, and the trees will help him. Now, I don't know how I'm going to do the trees. I think I want to keep the tops off the mountains. I do want them to feel like mountains, right? And usually the trees don't quite make it. Sometimes they make it to the top, but usually a tree doesn't make it to the top of the mountain because it's colder up there, it's rockier, you know, it's harder for a tree to get a good grip. And usually they kind of like hang around the base. Like a little dense patch there that fades out a little bit over here for scientific reasons. Maybe a cheeky little tree did make it up there, just one. I think that's too many in the middle. It's ruining my beautiful sight line. I need to kill some of these. I don't think it needs much. The trees do make a big difference though, and I want some on this mountain. It's just a little bit too bare. If we kind of... something like that. Now, how does this look on the savannah side? Eh, it doesn't really make a difference. I think it helps, but it's not a big deal. I think that looks really nice. I mean, the whole thing's kind of come together really nicely. To be honest, it just looks like a big, wet, tree-y field, but that's not the point. Look at that. I think this might be my favourite one. The hills just do so much for it. I really haven't been messing around with height nearly enough in this in all of my playthroughs. It's really important to having interesting parks. Now. Nope. I do want to hide the feeders still, and I want to hide them sort of all over the park as much as possible. Okay, so we've got three herbivore feeders in, so hopefully... I love that. I just want to look at my trikes like that all day. Really cool. Yeah. I'm in a good mood, folks. It's very rare. Just roll with me on this one, okay? And we also need a carnivore feeder. Nah. I think we're going to do a goat again. I'm going to stick it there. Kind of away from the herbivore feeders. For some reason, they added a tree, which is something I've never seen before. Usually it's the exact opposite, but there you go. Let's get more dinosaurs shifted over. I'm excited to see what this one looks like. Just temporarily, you know, when we've got all the herbivores in, there's no T-Rex, there's no carnivores, there's nothing else trying to kill everybody else. It's just the herbivores living their lives out. We're going to definitely take a little look at that before we move on. Right, so I've got one ankylosaurus, 4 Edmontosauruses, 6 Triceratopses. I'm just worried that 5 Struthiomimuses is going to be too many. But I don't want 5 Pachycephalosauruses. Maybe I don't need different numbers. We'll go for 3 Struthies, 3 Pachycephalosauruses. That sounds like a plan. Now, the best Struthi colour is obviously Rainforest. But you only allowed one of those because it's kind of fancy. So the other ones are going to be woodland. That's a really nice mix of sort of greens and blues. And we will replace those with the... I think we're only going to have 1 Rex as well. Oh, we can have 2 Pachycephalosaurus. Oh, they might get angry. No, we'll just have 2 Pachycephalosauruses. What's the best Rex? Let's go for Okay, yeah, that's cool. 1 Rex, 2 Pachycephalosauruses, 3 Struthiomimuses, 4 Edmontosauruses, 5 of nothing, because there is nothing left, 6 Triceratopses. Maybe I could kill a Triceratops. And that way I'd have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It would feel mean, but 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 would make me so happy. I'd like to have 2 Rexes in, but they don't get on, do they? So I think they should get on a bit more than they do, maybe. I don't think that's a lot of dinosaurs. But it's what it is. Hi-ho, Silver! Away! So many dinosaurs. So many dinosaurs. I'm just worried that if I went overboard with the Struthies and stuff, it would just look too busy. You know, I think there's a lot of value in having a lack of dinosaurs in your exhibits to an extent. Are you the only guys that... Right, we've got 1 Baryonyx. Yeah, both my Suchomimuses are dead, and one of my Baryonyxes is dead. RIP. I did want a better colour for this. Them, so. Only one. What? They just. Oh, that's not even a sticky. That's a parasol. Oh, no. I really need to replace some dinosaurs here. I still need to replace the Allosauruses in this one. I'll do it before the final tour. We'll do a final tour video tomorrow or Saturday or whatever, and I'll make sure all the dinosaur populations are back to relative normality before we do that. Where's that other Struffy? There you are. Okay. Good stuff. Honestly, half these videos. The ones where, because there's less building work in this series, I would say, a lot of this is really just me moving dinosaurs and talking absolute rubbish at the same time. But that's what you guys signed up for, so it's completely your fault. Okay, so I'm thinking. Okay, there. And that's how you get back. You have to go back through the first exhibit. Like so. And because that's very, very close to the initial gate. So you go through here, and you can either go that way and go all the way around, or you can go this way and go all the way around. It also means that when I come to tour this, I don't have to go see the entire bloody park. I can just go in there, but I think that looks really nice. Man, the hills. The hills are beautiful. They're alive with the sound of dinosaurs. That would be a much better film. Not that I ever watched Sound of Music, if I'm honest. Pachycephalosaurus, one of my more neglected dinosaurs in the game, although I say that every single time I make one, which has probably only been once. Now, I have no idea which colour I like for the Pachycephalosaurus. Not a clue. I know I don't, however, like the jungle one. I'm gonna go Savannah. We're gonna go for Arid. We're gonna go for whatever the other one that's not jungle is. Alpine. Who else just died? Stop dying, you nerds! Like Spinosaurus, I really like you, but you are ruining my day here. This is not a fair fight. No part of this is balanced. I can't believe I'm down to one parasaur. I think I have like six. Where have all my parasaurolophuses gone? I swear there's been an absolute slaughter that I've somehow missed. I had six of these zebras. And now I'm down to two majungasauruses and a Mementi. I'm really going to have to restock. At least all my dilos are alive. They should keep surviving. But still. Oh, through the tree. You're in there somewhere. Oh, there you are. That's a goat, actually. Asset in transit. Okay, so what do I need? I need an Allosaurus, a Stegosaurus. No, excuse me. I need an Allosaurus. I need a Stegosaurus. I need six Parasaurolophuses. Five. I've got mad hiccups all of a sudden. I also need, like, 10 Stegimolochs. I also need two Baryonyxes and two Sucumamuses. Right, I assume the Baryonyx, yes, the Baryonyx is now dead. It's now just two Spinosauruses. Just chilling with corpses everywhere. Spinosaurus is definitely the dominant dinosaur in this ecosystem. So, two Baryonyx, two Sucumimus, along with all the other stuff. And I will get all those in for the next episode. Bloody Nora. Only two dinosaurs. Oh, hello. A little shifty move there, aren't you, son? Let's take a look at our Edmontosauruses. Fair. Oh, is this rainforest? Tundra? I don't recognize this one. Some of the Edmontosauruses are really interesting, but then you look at the difference between these two, and it's like this tiny difference in the head. It's minuscule. And these two as well. Look at that. And then... Wait, no. Look at that one. And then look at that one. No, not that one. That one. It's basically, there's three shades of purplish blue that are either more purple or more blue, and there's no other change. And yet, then you look at this one, and it's completely different and crazy. I don't understand. I really don't. And there's some differences, like in the actual skin colour. You can see it's darker and sort of more brown-orange here, where it's got these sort of shades of yellow in this one, but this one's just so entirely different that it seems weird to me that it's unbalanced like that. But hey, what do I know? You know nothing. You get nothing. That's not even a quote. Oh, you're cute. I like this one. That's Savannah. You're a nervous little Nelly, aren't you, though? Come on, lad, get out. Oh my god, that's a neck. That's a neck and a half. Alright, pal, calm down. Arid, and there we go. That should be our final herbivore. get them shifted over, get our T-Rex shifted over, and we will go on a little tour. I was going to say, I'm not seeing any trikes, despite half the population of this entire thing being a trike. Oh, no, no, there you go. See there, fence. Who do you think you are? I want to go check in on our Anki. Are you happy? No. Population is way too high for the Ankylosaurus, which I should have assumed, actually, in retrospect, but it's not that big a deal. I really wish population... I don't understand why they're not. I don't. I think it was something to do with the computational power required. But why are population limits not determined by size of exhibit? How not... I mean, just say that out loud. That's nonsensical, right? Surely. That makes no sense. How can you be just as happy with the same number of dinosaurs if you have, like, a foot exhibit or, like, a 20-foot exhibit? The population requirement is space-dependent, not flat number-dependent. That should be, anyway. But they did have a reason. I think it was something to do with that. Like, there just wasn't the processing power. Although that might have been why we can't follow the dinosaurs into the trees. I know they mentioned it. Where are you, Chica? Well, we can get the Rex out anyway. Coastal? Oh no, Step. Wrong one. Coastal's my favourite, though. I think Step's pretty cool as well. Step's pretty cool as well. Can't go wrong with Steps. 5, 6, 7, 8. A boot so baby. I never got that lyric. It's a what so baby? A boot so? I always say boot so, but that doesn't make any sense. What's a boot so baby? Drive me a crazy. Got obsession with depression. Dance all day, Romeo. No, stay away from the Pachycephalosaurus. Away, away, away. 5, 6, 7, 8. Shoot! No, Fine, I'll get a new one. We need an arid pattern Pachycephalosaurus. Wait, do I have any double dinosaur? No, I don't think I've got anything I've only got two of, but we have three Stroofies. I was going to have two T-Rexes, but I didn't. Okay, no, we can just have two. Okay, well done, T-Rex. The T-Rex knew that this is what I really wanted. And let's just get rid of that corpse there. Get rid of all the corpses. How high is my rating going to go? My rating's pretty good, considering how little effort I put into facility. But that is where the problem is, rather predictably. Visibility 0, which I still don't know if that matters or not. But my drink rating and stuff like... We can fix that, though. We can do a little something about that. Just nip over here. Pull this up to the top. I've got no idea whether this... the what you're selling actually makes a difference at all. But, one day I'll figure it out. That's a lot of people crammed in there. I mean, it's a very popular park, right? And there's not really anywhere for anyone to go. But that is a lot of people in a very small... Oh, I'm getting like... Just... What are you doing? This is mass gobbledy horde. All walking... Like, nobody's walking here. There's like six people here. All my security people are walking down here because that's the ACU center. Nothing but security dudes and dudettes. All with obnoxious bloody Bluetooth things in their ears. Right? Yeah. Look at you. Just like this universal signifier that you're a terrible person. And you, Missy. Don't think I don't see you just because I'm inside your head. And you go over here and it's just... There's so many... We need a new plague. It's got cool hair though. Oh, hello. I was trying to... It's just weird. Oh my god, it makes me feel sick. At least some have made it down here. A couple of science dudes have made it over here. Oh, this looks cool, actually. All the science dudes. A couple of random stranglers kind of made it over here in this little threesome they've got going on. But generally speaking, it's just science people. Anyways. Rex is flying up. Is that my Rex? That is my Rex. That's it. Don't kill each other. Everyone else is dead. You're not allowed to kill each other. Right, so I need 2 Baryonyxes, 2 Suchomimus, 5 Parasaurolophus, assuming the other one still is alive, which it is not, it's dead. didn't even notice that one. 6 parasol offices, 12 stegomolochs or so, an Allosaurus and a Stegosaurus. I'm going to put all of those in and then we'll do a final full through tour in the next episode. Until then, let's go enjoy our herbivores before the Rex arrives. I might do 2 tours as well. I like the idea of doing the tour at night time as well, just to get a proper feel for it. I don't know what that means. Bomb. There we go. It really does feel like an... There's no fence. You just can't see the fence. You can't see the gate. The massive hill. Even as you go up it, you can't see anything. You just see... Ignore the T-Rex falling from the sky over the night. You just see dinosaurs. How bad would that be, though? You've just been living this good life and then someone airdrops the Tyrannosaurus Rex right by your face. You'd be a little annoyed. I'd be a little annoyed. Going in. I actually want me to hit F2 there. Reverse. Oh, excuse me again. Bloody Nora. Reverse. Okay, I want to try and zoom in on the Rex and keep the Jeep in the shot. Something like that. How are we doing? This feels like risky business, I'm not gonna lie. Oh, hello. Did you just snap at me, son? Oh, he is off. Let's follow him. Is he going for the trike? I think so. Ooh! Run, trike, run! Work together, friends. Work together. Pack defense. This is what you were good at. Anyways, while he's gone off somewhere else, let's have a little wander about. It's definitely one of the more open exhibits. There's not many like sight lines where you can't see the entire thing, but that's kind of what I wanted. I love that Edmontosaurus skin, I really do. Exactly, that's why I told her. Well, yeah. Hello. I like this one. Welcome to Hell Creek, ladies and gentlemen. I'm gonna go find the Anki. There's something over there, what's that? Edmonto and a Struthi. Where's my Ankylosaurus? It was around here, and it's an Ankylosaurus, so I have to assume it hasn't gone that far. Curl around the top. Oh, hello! Having a little top of the mountain chinwag, aren't we? You can look down. Oh my god, they're all here. Hello! There's a whole crew of dinosaurs. 4 stegos, or trikes even, just hanging around. You can look down into the savannah as well, which will matter when there's actually dinosaurs in my savannah exhibit, which of course right now there isn't. You can just get a glimpse in the distance of the Isla Nublar welcome sign. It's pretty cool. Where on earth is my Ankylosaurus? Anky! I see trikes. I see nothing but trikes. I know there's more of them than everything else. This is how it should be, you know? This is the balance I wanted, but still. Oh, there's Rexy. Nope. Hard pass. I'm out of here, son. I want to find the Ankylosaurus. Right, tell you what. There it is. Right, to the north. Onwards. Alonzi. And so forth. I have a general manner. What's this wee little wire thing on the right hand side? I've only just noticed that. What's this? What's this right here? What's this meant to be? Also, who's low health? Wait, who is low health? Nobody's low health. Fantastic. Stay away. What is this wire? I've never noticed that before. Is it like an antenna kind of thing? I don't like it. It's really annoying me now that I've spotted, now that I've noticed it. It's really annoying me. Stupid wire. Ugh. Just don't look at the right hand side of the car. Oh god. Ah! stand up. Whee! It's like a rally track and an exhibit. Oh, there we go. Will you stop ruining things for me? I'm trying to look at the dinosaurs. You scared away my Ankylosaurus! Now, how much cooler would it be if it could tear the Jeep in half and kill me? That would be pretty baller, I think we can all agree. This Anky's got moves, man, look at him go. Trying scrolling up to each other. Is this their maximum social need? You still follow this? You ruin everything! Check that, I'm curious. Yeah, it is actually. I've never seen this before. That trike social dance, you know, where they try to beat each other up or threaten to beat each other up. Right, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to end it there. Of course, we will do a full tour. I will replenish the many, many dead dinosaurs, and we'll do a full tour at daytime, and we'll probably go do a full tour at nighttime as well. And I will turn on the rain. Because I think that'll look pretty cool. Thank you for joining me. Cheers. Much love as always. If you did enjoy this series and this video, please do hit the like button. It really helps me out. And I'll see you lovely folks next time. Cheers. Much love as always. I think I said that like 3 times now. Bye bye. A little shout out at the end. This video and others like it would not be possible at all without the support of you guys watching me at home and also everyone on this Patreon page right here who supported me in the last month. If you want to help out as well, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. Every little really helps. Cheers.